So now when now Deepa has asked about this Navadha Bhakti, what is this Navadha Bhakti? Now when you say Bhakti, there you, it is not an act in itself. Bhakti for someone. You already Bhagwan, if you do not assume, then whose Bhakti you are doing? So that is the importance again, this every time we say that first you have to be clear about the existence of the one. Then only you move towards it. So bhakti, so nine kind of bhakti means, bhakti is again, bhakti has so many forms. Ultimately, what does this bhakti means? Becoming nearer to God, serving to God. That is bhakti. So there are all, so many saints which we know that they kept on reaching nearer and nearer, and they realized more and more, becoming one. So they say there are nine kinds of bhakti described according to different times, depending on the attained ones or incarnation. It little bit form changes there. During Krishna's time, it is something else. Just during Ram's time, something else. Little bit difference is there. But for a human being's perspective, in today's human beings, it is better what has been described in Ram's period. Because that is maryada, that is etiquette. While Krishna's peers, it is more of a very highly attained saints. Those who are already liberated, they only can understand what it is. Otherwise, it cannot be understood. Bhakti during Ram's period can be understood today in the current period very well. Because it is with etiquette. So, they say, what is the first? Pratham bhakti santan kar sanga. Duji rati mam katha prasanga. First devotion is first step to associate with the saints. Go near saints. Sit with the saints. Now that comes to the second thing. Who is a saint? So that, to that some lakshan, they say, santan ke lakshan sun bhrata. Agnit Surti Puran Vikhyata. They are Agnit, cannot be counted. What are the qualities of the saint? But still, to recognize, you need to have few, otherwise, how will you know that who is a saint? Because ultimately, what saints' qualities are, those are God's qualities also, in a finer and more essential way. So, they say, to be Parahit, those who are involved in Parahit. Sant sahi dukh parhit lagi or par dukh lag asant avagi. Saintly quality is for the parahit. Then again, parahit, if you take in material form, then it is if you do some service to others. In common parlance, I am using this word. That is called parahit. But par ultimately refers to the God. Parahit means those you move them towards divinity. So for that sake, moving others towards divinity, those are saints. They will undergo certain pains if they, it is causal to moving others towards divinity. Sant sahai dukh parhit lagi. Or who is asant? Because once you say saint, then who is non-saint? Par dukh lag asant tabhagi. If you are ready to undergo some pain, to cause pain to somebody else, that even if I am in pain, but this may cause other also some pain. Let me or let him also or her also feel the pinch what I have done. Then you are a sant. So these are the difference. Then some example can be given, which are like if you cut with an axe a chandan tree, then even if that axe is like axe is cutting it, but chandan tree we are taking as a saint. Fragrance will come to the axe. Even when they are being made to suffer, some good thing, whatever is with them, they will impart you. So, saint is a very ordinary person that accepts everything. Okay, you are doing this, but I have only this. Those who have become in that, so those are the saints. This is something. And what is this? Sant means they will be all the time devoted to the divinity. They have become such that they have become almost like that, because no, except God, nobody can be God. God is only God, and nobody can be that. But all can become one with that. So saints have moved in that direction, and they are becoming more and more one with that. So all those quality which be assigned to the divinity, all those quality are in saints also, like forgiveness, kindness, all those things. But volume will be according to the capacity. You can be compassionate to someone to the extent you can be. So those are the qualities. So pratham bhakti santan kar sangha. First step moving towards bhakti devotion is associating oneself with the saints. Duji rati mam katha prasanga. Then second is, when you are with the saints, what they will be telling mostly about? Only divinity. So then your interest will also be created in that. That katha prasanga means what? There are two, formless and with form. Divinity formless and divinity formless. So what is the difference? Another way of saying this is between saint and God. God cannot be seen. Saints can be seen. So qualities which are there in the unseen, you are experiencing that in the association of seen one, whom you can see and talk to. So that is why even it is said, Mohite adhik guru hi jiye jani, sakal bhav pujai sanmani. This will also come into this Navadha Bhakti, but somewhere Ram tells, where should I stay? Then Valmiki tells, the one who knows guru more than you, that he is telling to the God himself. You stay in those hearts. So pratham bhagati santan kar sangha, duji ratimam katha prasanga. Then you start developing your interest into my stories, pastimes. Guru pad pankaj puja, tisari bhagati yaman, chauthi bhagati mam gungan karai kapat taj gaan. Guru pad pankaj puja means what? That means you have now become saint. Until you have become saint, you cannot know, cannot have that correct inclination towards Guru, because Guru is not a person. Though there is a body, because we cannot, without having a, that is what we are saying, a saint is, but God is not visible. So that is, he said, no, no, I have experienced something, it is open to you. So when we have become saintly, then only we can know what Guru is. That is why the saint only spoke about Gurus mostly, like Kabir. You saw how hyperbolic style he spoke about Guru. Because he realized now that this is true. What has Guru got to do with it? May even not be knowing, unconcerned with what is happening. Because if he has that beingness, that means he is no Guru. Guru means despite being form, there is no form left in him. Despite being life, there is nothing left in him. Then only is Guru. Otherwise, where is the Guru? Because Guru is, despite being a person, he is not a person. That only a saint can realize. Why only saints can experience divinity? Because they have become in that direction. Now they can understand. Now they can feel, they can experience. So Guru Pad Pankaj Puja, then you start worshipping. They say Pad Pankaj Puja, then every word is important. Why this has been placed like that? Lotus feet. Why lotus? You see, all the divinity, all things are lotus. Eyes are lotus. Hands are lotus. Feet are lotus. What does it mean? That means all the senses, they have become so pure that they can convert filth into fragrance. Like a lotus, all senses have become like that. That is why they are called lotus. It is not that they are in that color or something like that. So, Guru Pad Pankaj Puja, because it has become like that, so we worship that. Worship means we want to be like that. Now we are moving into that. So we have a model. that this is the way. We have a path teller, path shower, that look, this is the way to go. Guru Pada Pankaj Puja Tisari Bhagat Aman. What will happen? If we associate with Guru, then we will become Aman. Aman means we will not have this desire for our being honored, that I should also get respect. Because so long as I is there, whether you want it or not, you will hanker for respect. Less and less I will become, more and more you will become oblivious to the respect. Then it will automatically come. But so far you are looking for it, you are nourishing your ego, nothing. So he says in association, you know, this thing will go. Then what will happen? Then second thing become the first. Guru Pada Pankaj Puja Tisari Bhagat Aman Chauthi Bhagat In Mam Gun Gan Karai Kapat Tajgan. When your respects, this thing is gone, ego is gone. And what happened? You have developed interest into Harikatha, means in the divinity. Then your ego is also gone. Now what work is left with you other than singing the glory of God? So then you have entered into the fourth step. Chauthi Bhagati, and how it happened with the Guru. What is the role of the Guru? So it says in the very beginning, Siri Guru Pad Nakh Madigan Jyoti Sumirat Divya Drishti Hi Hoti Dalan Mohitam Sosa Prakasu Bade Bhag Ur Aavai Jasu Ugharahi Vimal Bilochan Hi Ke Mitahi Dosh Dukh Bhav Rajni Ke Sujahi Ram Charit Mani Mane Gupt Prakat Jahan Jojahi Khane. How it begins? The Sri Guru Padanak Manigan Jyoti. If we really know the Guru, how is this? Then he said it is Manigan, means like so many jewels or stars. That much light is there. And then you remember. Sumrat means what is our Smriti Yoga says, remembrance. So then Divya Drishti Hi Hoti. Then in your heart, Divya Drishti means divine light will come. Talan Mohitam, when the light comes in the heart, what will happen? Your ignorance will go because of that light. Bade Bhagur, if you are very fortunate that it comes, then Ugharai Bimal Bilochan Eke, eyes of the heart has opened, that means wisdom has come. Mitain Dosh Dukh Bhavraj, then all the sorrows of the world are gone because world does not exist. So where is the sorrow? That is what the saints say, no, there is something which is not there, why people are looking for that everywhere? Sujhai Ram Charan Mani Manik, then you see divinity everywhere, Gupta Prakat, wherever it has to be seen. Jahan Jai Jahin Khanik, as much capable one has become, because that is infinite. So, that Chauthi Bhagati Mam Gungan Karai Kapat Tajdan, because he has seen with the eyes of that divinity through Guru, now his eyes are open. So he will also start singing. Because his ego is gone, so whatever is being told, it is all about divinity. It is not about, when we say mam, word in Sanskrit, it is my. It is not about that. It is referring to the soul. Mam is always referring here to the divinity. Ultimate, in ultimate sense. So mam gungan means not somebody's gungan, it is divinity. But that has to be according to the experience. Mantra jap mam dhra vishwasa pancham bhagati subhet prakasa. Mantra jap kya hai? What is the mantra jap? It is solid faith. When you have become, faith has concretized. Faith is a happening. It's a nahi hai. Somebody says, main unme bada vishwas karta hun. I have so much faith in him. It is useless. You do not have faith in anyone. You become faith. It is a happening. When wisdom comes, so your intelligence shines forth. It reaches to the... Wisdom is not against intelligence, it is not against ego, it is not against mind. It gives them light, look, see yourself how you are, where is your limitation. Intelligence, when it is pure, it is divine. Ego, when it is pure, it is ahankar shuddh. Means the whole creation is ego. How to balance it? How it is? Existence. Identity. So these are not negative things. With faith all become clear that this is how, then only faith develops. Then it is a happening. Otherwise, what happens? Wrong things, wrong way, because it is ignorance which is leading. You trust Guru. That is one thing. Why you trust? Because you think X or Y is Y or Z is wise. That is why you trust. You are trusting ultimately wisdom, which is you inside you. So that is the word. Correctly. Mantra jap mam drad vishwasa. So when that faith, it has reached to the stage of faith, that becomes your mantra. Mantra is not something chanting, because people interpret it this way, it is not correct way. It is very shallow way of that. It is also there, if you have experience till then only, then it is fine. You japo whatever mantra has been given to you, but it is a like throwing stones onto the god. It is not that much a deep thing. Once you have refined better, mantra jap mam drad vishwasa. Mantra is, if you have become, like your faith has now grown inside you, you have become wise. Pancham bhagati subhed prakasa. Then what will happen when your that faith has become so firm? Then ved prakasa, knowledge will come inside, from inside you, because that is where it rests, inside you, nothing outside. There is no difference between inside and outside. Because for the sake of convenience, you are one piece, so we say inside. Once you start seeing, you are no more one piece. You are nowhere and you are everywhere. Then where is the in and where is the out? So for the sake of that, because you appear to be in one piece, so we say drad viswas in yourself. So then knowledge will come from within you. छठ दम सील विरति बहुकर्मा निरत निरंतर सज्जन धर्मा. सो वेन लाइट हैज कम व्हाट विल हैपन देन यू आर सी ऑल द यम नियम सील दिस थिंग विल कम. यम नियम मीन्स नाउ यू आर वी कॉल इन आवर टू डेज वोकैबुलरी और दैट रेगुलेशन एंड मॉडरेशन ऑफ सेंसेस ऑफ माइंड ऑफ एवरीथिंग. So, chhat dam seal, that is dam and seal. Seal means character, devahar. So many names, but character you see it as chhat dam seal virati bahu karma. Then your character starts, self starts developing. Because now light is there. Now you see clarity, clearly what is there. Virati bahu karma. Then other all kinds of karmas which you earlier you were doing, now you know in light, oh, these are useless. Nirat nirantar sajjan dharma. But what will become? It is not that now I have come to know it is useless, so I sit idle. No, you will work more. 24 hours then you will start work. Nirat nirantar sajjan dharma. But what will happen? You will now be doing the work of sajjan. That santajan. Sajjan means it is a santajan. Means saints, which are supposed to, saints are supposed to do. Because now you have moved very near. So what is the sense work? He says he sees everywhere divinity. So whatever work is, it is universal relevance. There is no for small, there is no difference for small unit and big unit. When one's heart has become with such much light, that only in universal work he has started seeing that his work is also gets done. So there is no difference between this and that. So that is why the sarvabhut hite rata. What is the saint? They are working for all, whole creation. You see, some see, oh no, I am limited, my work is limited to my family. Some say, no, my family is whole earth. Some say, no, my family is universe. Some say, no, my family, all universes are included in my family. So it depends how much expansion of one's wisdom has happened. So sarvabhut hite rata, according to one's capacity. Nirat nirantar. Usme the word given is nirat means all the time, nirantar, continuously. they are working. They have become like this, now they are working 24 by 7, while sleeping, waking, dreaming, all the time work is they are doing. Saptam sam mohimay jag dekha. A mohite adhik sant kari lekha. That is what. Now, who is telling this? This is Ram telling this. Navadha Bhakti was told by Ram to Shabri, one of the devotees. And how was she? His guru told her this. He said she was serving all the time in ashram. Then Matang Rishi's ashram. Then Rishi told him. Then he just was moved one day. So he said, oh, you have served so many days. You have been serving. I did not know. What do you want? She said, nothing. I was just serving. Then he says, okay, then you sit here. God will come to see you. People, I send people to the God, but he'll come to see you. Just sit here. So, when he came, so he himself narrated. So this point I remember that saptam sam mohimay jag lekha, a mohite adhik sant kari lekha. Earlier it was Valmiki who was telling, when Ram asked, God asked that, where should I stay? He is asking to the seer sense. That itself speaks how close saints are to the God. Here he himself is telling. Saptam sam. If when you reach to the seventh step, you become even to all. You become even. Now, to all in a way is useless word. You become even. So all where is even? You become even. So you even to all. It is already included in this. Like this, people pay bhav, sad bhav. Sad is not needed with bhav. It is already there, sad. Bhav means sad bhav only. Haan, if you have kubhav, then you have to say kubhav. But bhav itself includes sad. So when you are even to all. Saptam sam mohimay jag dekha. He said, why even? Because they are seeing this whole world in me. It is filled with me. And he says, mohite adhik sant kari lekha. And more than me, they give value to the saints. Why did he say this? Because he knows that I am not available in human form everywhere. Saints are available. So they know how to reach me. So it will be easier for us to reach him. So he is making it easier. And as we say, no, what is the quality? How do you know that somebody has is reached towards perfection? If he or she can make things simple, that means he is reaching towards perfection. Now God is saying, more than me value saints. But here it says that saints, Samala, these days when people say, no, you have been declared saints. It is not correct. In Sanatan Parampara, how it happens? They go other way around. Tulsidas, it so happened that he was writing his Ramcharitmanas. And he kept in a small kutir there. So there some, these pandits, they always intellectual pandit, Gyanijan, they had developed an envy to him, jealousy, that look, his saint is staying there. And everybody is going to him, and he was a very simple person. In one corner, making a small hut and staying. And he said, he is writing something, so they instigated two thieves, go and steal that. So these two thieves went there to steal, so they saw that two people are circling it with bow and arrow. And those thieves' mind got changed. So they left that place. Morning they came to Tulsidas and say, look, I had come, my heart is changed now, we are no more thieves. Something happened in their presence, two people were there, maybe they came from somewhere, but they were with bows and arrows and they were taking round. Now he may or may not know, he only said maybe from somewhere they came, but looking at them I got transformed, now I know. But Tulsidas knew who they were. So he burned his hut. He said, if God has to come to protect me, hell with this such thing. So they run away from miracles, that people should not come to know that miracles are happening. Here, if you do miracle, then you are declared a saint. So you are reducing. Saint is being very ordinary. That every, then you are giving hope to every human being that you can also become the same. And that is the idea. It is not a special position. No, no, I only can attain it. No. It is open for all in equal measure. So, Mohite Adhik Sant Kari Lekha, that says if real saint is there, then you have to see him more than me, because I am toh available everywhere and at my will I can create myself. For me there are no boundaries, neither material nor others. Neither I am bound by material and nor I am confined by it. That means in material world I can do anything, and beyond material world also I can do anything. For me there is no dearth. But for saints, they have a frame, they have to go according to ordinary. So who is suffering more, they or I? I anyway do not suffer. That is how he says, Mohite Adhik Sant Kari Lekha, because they, for my sake, they are undergoing this much pain. For whose sake? For his devotees' sake. Saptam Sam Mohim Maya Jagdekha Mohite Adhik Sant Kari Lekha Astam Jada Lav Santosha Sapneo Nahi Dekhai Pardosha. And then the eighth step, Yatha Lav Santosha, all the time contented. You know, because when you see divinity everywhere, then why should not you be contented? So all the time it is, whether you are undergoing loss, then also you will take it as if it is a benefit only. That is the quality. How do you know that you are contented? When loss and this benefit both appear same. Some lost kanchanam. That is how Gita says that even soil, the dust full of soil or dust full of gold, they appear same. So, astam jatha lav santosa, any kind of, this is material thing. It is not, I am saying, even spiritually, what is going, what is coming, contented. Astam jatha lav santosa sapneo nahi dekhai paradosha, and they do not see any, what you call, that somebody is lacking this, any weaknesses, any dosh, they do not see others defects. Sapneo nahi dekhai paradosha, it has two meanings also. Like, let me tell you now, later I may tell so many others. But paradosha means they are not seeing any lack in divinity also. That God has this defect. This is lacking in God. That if that is there, that should come in the form of inquiry. Whether it is, that is why we go to Guru. But we cannot say that mere saath Bhagwan ne bada bura kar diya. That means you are seeing defect in God. No, no, mujhe toh bada bharosa tha, I was very having so much faith in God, but he has done this to me. That means you have not, you are very ignorant. So one meaning is that. And when I say see other divine, that means you are not supposed to see defects in other. It is only Guru, because he does it for a purpose, to correct it. They say antar haat sahar de bahar bahe chot. He has to, it is a painful job he has to do. That from inside you have to support and from top you have to, then only it comes into the shape. And then a picture, the make, no, earlier they used to make, nowadays how they are making. So antar, that quality, because we see defect, then we do not give that inside hand. We just see defect, so that should not be seen. When I am saying seed other divine, that means that in that sense also it is par. So do not see defect. Astam jatha lav santosa sapneo nahi dekhai pardosha. Now navam saral savsan chalhina mam bharosh hiye harasin adina. Ninth step is saral. It becomes very spontaneous, which we call sahaj. Sahaj Saral. Navam saral sabsan chalhina. No, there is no difference left. With everyone, one is same. Sab, with no deception at all. Chalhina means devoid of deception. No duality is left. No image is left. No, something is coming right now, it is coming. Oh, what will be? Okay, it will be like this. So there is nothing left. Sabsan chalhina. The behavior should be without any deception. Mam bharos hi harashna bina. And my, this thing, mam bharos means divines, that essence, that confidence, super confidence of super soul. Mam bharos hi harashna bina. What is there in the heart? Only my confidence is left. Neither any kind of visible happiness or neither any kind of sorrow. One meaning is that it depends on whose experience is how. Another meaning is mam bharos hiye harash. Means in heart there is only happiness and my confidence and no sorrow. That is another meaning. Now that is in degrees. As we experience inside, we know without any doubt what does it mean. So whatever is written in Shastras, these are, I am saying time and again, experiences of saints. That is the value of Shastras. If you blindly follow them, that may turn into a ritual. It may give you an impression, nothing more than that. But if you go and experience, that's why I say you experience and move. Experiment, experience and move, yes, it works, then only it is real. In reality is reality in all aspects. So this is the way. These are the nine kinds of bhaktis, ways, steps, whatever you call them. And he says, nau mah jinke ekahu hoi. Even if one has only one among all these nine. So that person is Atishay Priyamuli. That person is very dear to me. Sakal Prakar Bhakti Dhratore. And he says to Shabri, you have all these nines. I have told this for the people's sake. So that was the about Navadha Bhakti. Because bhakti is simple. Jnana Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, three ways there are told, and they are intermingled, they are not exclusive. Jnana Yoga means it is like Pradhanta, who has little more that. Somebody has oriented little more towards devotion, bhakti. Somebody is oriented little more towards knowledge. Somebody is little more oriented towards karma. But it is not that other two are not there. Because that no being is incomplete. In all the beings, all things are there. But karma pradhan. Somebody tilted towards. Somebody is more oriented towards knowledge. Somebody is more towards work. That is how it is. Devotion. So that is how it has been told.